So far, you've only achieved results based on the scanline renderer and non-physically based lights and materials. Now, you switch to the mental ray renderer and see what it has to offer. Keep on working on your scene or open the file environment.mr.max to pick up where the last movie left off. Before you switch rendering engines, keep in mind that a few options you used earlier are not quite compatible with mental ray. The light tracer engine you used earlier, for example, is not compatible with mental ray at all. Another feature that is pseudo-compatible, but not meant to be used with mental ray, is the standard matte shadow material. To see how mental ray affects these two features, make sure you can see both the advanced lighting panel and the slate material editor. Sure enough, because you are set with the scanline renderer, you can see both the light tracer parameters and the matte shadow material type in the standard materials list. In the Common tab of the Render Setup dialog, switch from scanline to mental ray. Notice how you lose the advanced lighting panel and the matte shadow material type, along with a few other options that are incompatible with mental ray. The existing matte shadow material node, however, is still in the viewer. Try to render the camera view, and you will see that it's still collecting shadows as it should. This is why I mentioned that it's pseudo-compatible, even though you want to use a similar yet different material when using mental ray. You'll get to that in a moment. First, you need to adjust the lighting. Close the Material Editor and the Render Setup dialog. Select the Daylight System and go to the Modify panel. The sunlight is currently provided by a standard light. As mentioned before, this is just a standard direct light and is not physically accurate. Instead, choose the MR Sun option, which is a photometric light and acts closer to how sunlight should behave. This means, among other things, that you wouldn't need to worry about position and beam sizes anymore. The skylight option is still used from earlier. This will do for now. We'll come back to it in a minute. Now press 8 to go to the environment dialog. The exposure control is still set to logarithmic from earlier. When using mental ray with a daylight system based on MR Sun, you want to use the MR photographic exposure instead. Earlier, when you created the daylight system, you were prompted to use a logarithmic exposure because the scanline renderer was current. If you already had mental ray specified as a rendering engine, you would have been prompted to use the MR photographic exposure instead. This means you wouldn't have had to change it manually as you are doing now. If you render the scene now, you'll notice that it's very, very dark. This is due to a combination of factors. The MR photographic exposure is designed to take advantage of HDR, high dynamic range photography, and of photometric lights. The skylight used in the scene is closer to a standard light and is not physically accurate. In fact, if you temporarily switch the skylight option to MR Sky and render again, you'll see a significant difference. MR Sky uses an HDR gradient map to light the environment. It's still a little dark because you haven't fine-tuned the lighting yet. Also, the background used in the scene is a simple JPEG picture. An average person would want to use regular photography and still get decent results. Most point-and-shoot cameras and smartphones output JPEG files, and that's the file type you're most likely to use. Here's another problem to overcome when using non-HDR photography. Go to the Slate Material Editor. You need to replace the matte shadow material used earlier with one that is fully compatible with mental ray. From the mental ray materials list, drag a matte shadow reflection material into the viewer. Double-click the node to see the material's properties. It is similar in concept to the standard matte shadow material, but has a slightly different behavior. You actually need to specify the background used for final render, in this case, the bitmap used as a camera backplate. Simply wire that bitmap to the camera mapped background channel and apply the material to the ground plane. Render the scene again. This is not exactly what you anticipated. This is happening because the matte shadow reflections material was not designed to be physically accurate. Because of that, you need to adjust the exposure differently to handle the scene better. In the environment dialog, note that the physical scale is set to physical units, candelas per meter square. This is fine for HDR photography, but not for your average JPEG images, and not when using the shadow matte reflections material. Set it to unitless instead. What you need to do now is figure out the right value to punch in. A good rule of thumb is to start at 50,000 and work your way up. At 50,000, the render is brighter, but you can certainly make out the borders of the matte shadow plane. Increase the unitless value until the borders start to blend with the walkway. At 70,000, it's already getting better. You may choose to elect to change the exposure value a bit. Try it in EV mode at 14 and test render once more. Much better. The render looks brighter and you can barely make out the ground borders, but a closer inspection shows that they are still there. Higher in the panel, enable the Process Background and Environment Maps option. This actually affects the image in the background to fit the rest of the scene lighting, thus eliminating the borders with the matte shadow plane. Finally, double-click the matte shadow material node in the Slate Material Editor. In the Shadows rollout, bring down the ambient shadow intensity to 0 to darken the shadows and render again. The lighting is working much better now, and the shadows are not as crisp as they were when using the scanline renderer. However, the materials are a bit washed out. The booth is only using standard materials, and they don't react too well with Mentor Ray. There are some bitmaps used to mimic reflections, and some transparency for glass, but neither is working too well. In the next movie, you tackle materials that will work better when using Mentor Ray.